that runs Snap games. So to do that, I obviously either want to do a PowerPoint presentation, so I get a Snap project, and that project is actually a game, a retro game called The Quest for the Snap Arcade Machine, with this retro effect. So let me show you how you get to the point where you start with nothing and end up with a full-size arcade cabinet. The way you do it is you start by finding some friends. In our case, our character here is Rita, a friend of mine, who's a very active person in the Catalan Snap community. And she's jumping around the city, looking for friends. No friends here.
This is a shaky.
Her idea was to build an arcade machine where the games themselves would be programmed by the people who played them later. Playing an arcade machine is not a very educational thing, so the idea is we want to bring back the spirit of the arcade, but we want to make it educational, so we get to write the programs that will power the machine later. So that's me and Chris jumping in there. I'm sure you can recognize us. And Rita found us, and she said, we need to find a makerspace. Because we need to cut the panels for the machine, right? So we started designing the machine, went through a couple of iterations. I'll show you later what those iterations look like. And in Barcelona, there are lots of makerspaces. We had quite a lot of trouble because it was a new thing for us. We had never used a CNC before or anything like that. But we finally found a makerspace in Barcelona that had very helpful staff who could guide us through the process of turning a 3D model that we had built into something that a CNC machine could understand.
Can you turn the volume down a little bit? You're yelling over the music. Is there a way to turn it
off? Oh, sure, sorry.
Thank you.
So the next step was to gather some materials. We now had the panels cut for the machine, but we needed to put something inside the wooden thing. And the first thing we needed was a computer. What else? We needed a screen, which was not an easy feat, because you know, nowadays screens are all 19 by 9, right? But we needed a 4 by 3 screen, so we had to find second-hand shops who would steal some old screens. We also needed a way to control the joysticks and so on, and for that we used what you can clearly see is an Arduino board. Yeah, pixels. And what else? Well, we needed the actual joysticks, which were surprisingly easy to find. It seems that retro is doing a comeback, so we have all these online shops where you can buy real arcade machine joysticks. And, of course, buttons as well. And these buttons are funnily called, that's their real name, anti-pandemic buttons. Because they're made so that kids can actually abuse them and they won't break. So you can try to vandalize them all you want. They're indestructible. Okay, so we have our materials. We need to assemble the machine now. And for that, we gathered the whole team. And then we went, we found a space where we could buy it, assemble it. Here's the two of us waiting for Rita to check on the materials. So she's making sure everything's all right. Okay, everything's all right, we can start assembling. So we get our tools, we start building up the machine. And we're done, right? No, we're not. We need to art it. We need to paint it. So let's get some paint. Actually, here I'm lying a little bit. We didn't do that. An artist collective did that. Because if we had, then the machine would have looked something like this. It looked far more beautiful, although we didn't have a lot of that. So the next thing we need to do is to actually create games for the machine. but with Snap. And we go through the journey of stringing blocks together in the scripting area, looking for Alonso until our game is done. And the next step is to play our game. So let's play the game we've just made. And you have to imagine, of course, that we're here in an actual arcade cabinet. I know it's not the same. So the feeling of playing a game, however simple it is that you've made, playing it in a real machine, it really brings you back to, at least to my childhood, where sometimes I really missed the school bus because in the cafeteria where we had breakfast, there was an arcade machine next to the bus stop, and we would play there and challenge each other, and many a morning we almost missed the bus. Looking for the high score. Oh, in a story it seems. Something failed. Okay, now for real, let me show you how we build this thing.
Made by one of the BJC students, and we turned it into an arcade game.
here's me and Chris playing the retro home game that I did. The game is as exciting as it was. Thank you.